get to the
post office because for some reason I need to mail my rent. So I finally got those pimple patches because I don't know what happened here, but she turned into a monster. Why have I been so naive? They're amazing. It's the first of the month. Happy March. Last month was kind of crazy. I had my trip. Interested to see what's in store. I'm also really wearing a couture sweatsuit and Uggs. Like I'm back in middle school and I'm here for it. It's literally 66 degrees out. Feels so beautiful, so nice. I'm on my way to Emily's in the West Village. It's this really good pizza burger spot that my friend Haley really wants to go to. Meeting up with both Haley and Marissa. There's the fit thrifted, what is this? Zip up thrifted jean, thrifted coach purse, thrifted skirt. Forget where the tights are from, and Steve Bannon loafers. And then Patterson.
Just showing your gifts.
But they're so cute.
We made a decision to come into Soho, and then even worse decision to go into Sephora in Soho. I'm traumatized. Oh my God, remember when I said I'll see you in March? See you in March? And it's a leap year.
I was like, oh my God, and now it's March, and I still haven't seen her yet.
It's March,
yeah.
And now we're back.
Vanilla latte, matcha almond,
oats,
matcha oat,
matcha almond.
Matcha almond.
It matches. Am I gonna match with her bag?
I gotta say,
not even close.
9 out of 10.
Pretty
good. I would say 10 out of 10. It's like a little.
I could use a little more honey in this. A
little sweet, but
it's hitting.
Let's go.
Good coffee at 5 o'clock at night.
Currently waiting for Danny outside of this restaurant. I signed up for this thing called like 222. They had it in LA and then they were coming to New York, so I signed up for it. It's just like a way to like meet new people in the city. To be honest, I have no idea.
I see possible futures all at once, but I do see a way.
Sweater, dress pants, loafers. It's actually disgusting. It's raining. Soho is my favorite, like, architectural wise area of Manhattan, but I can't handle having to walk in Soho on a weekend. It drives me insane. I also have to drop off some film in Chinatown, so we're gonna do that as well. Hi, can I do the sun latte, please?
I need more jewelry. I need more clink
clink. God damn it, you need more jewelry.
I do.
This is contact with muscle.
But at the same time, like.
Just had lunch at, what was it, Ruby's?
Yeah, Little Ruby's.
Little Ruby's in Soho, and now.
So bomb.
So good. I got the soup.
I got creamy chicken, something fucking really, really good.
She got like a pasta. Like a spicy, yeah, was it really, the spicy one?
No, it wasn't spicy. I had like sun-dried tomatoes. It was really delicious.
Yes. I had a little soupy because it's cold and gross outside.
It's soup day.
But we're on our way to Elise Digital, where is, you know, I'm not, I spoke English. where I get my film developed, and I have a lot of film from my trip to Thailand and the Philippines that I'm excited to develop and see if they're any good.
All right, guys.
Ta-ta.
Chip, chip, chip.
I ended up getting my cards read. I have a reader that was there at that cafe. Never actually gotten my cards read before. I've had them read by people that were practicing. It's interesting, I didn't know what to expect. She was like, anyone can come through, you know, I'll read the cards and then you can tell me what this resonates with. Like, you'll know if this has to do with you, a friend. The first one that she read, someone's coming out of a bad situation, they're released. And I was like, that's not me, but I feel like I know who this is. Like, my friend that I was with, I was like, that's her. And the next one was about manipulation. Someone was involved with the manipulation and it's come to an end. And the first thing I thought about was my most recent, wasn't aware we weren't friends anymore until I found out she blocked me yesterday. And I do feel like there's a heavy manipulation and third party. And she asked me if I was stagnant in my job. And initially I was like, no, my job is pretty good, but however, I do have like my videos, like I have my YouTube, I make videos, which I hope be my job one day. And she was like, don't call it a hobby, that's like making it insignificant. Call it your work, call it your project, call it your job. I have started, when I was on vacation with my mom, I was like, mom, I gotta work. And I was filming my TikTok or filming my short or filming my YouTube. And then she was like, is there a difficult man? I was like,
yes, when is there not a difficult man?
She said that this man was, she didn't say insecure, but along those lines, insecure, questioning things in his life. That's like kind of why it didn't work out. Someone within this relationship is ready to move forward, whether if that's like together or apart. The person I immediately thought of, I was just like, yes, that makes sense. Like, I want to say that it's me, but I still sometimes cross my mind. Then, right afterwards, she, supportive man in your life. And she's like, is it this person? I was like, absolutely not. It is not that person. But someone does come to mind. And she said, she described their work to me. And I was like, yes, that's pretty accurate to, like, the person I'm thinking about. And then she just said, you know, they're just not, they haven't found their place yet. But she didn't really say if it had anything to do with, like, our relationship or not. It's fine, because I knew that. I knew that about this person. And I was just like, yeah, me and them are not. I went into the reading hoping to find clarity on some things. However, just kind of told me things that I already knew, which they were accurate. Like, they were accurate things. Like, nothing she said was really like, no, like, they're all accurate. There were kind of some specifics. So it's not like it was a bad reading. Like, the person was bad. I think they were a very good person and I really liked her and her energy. I'm happy I did, but I just didn't bring me any clarity. And then I came home and I sat here literally like this, stared at the ceiling and just cried. It's the first beautiful day that I can go to my little lunch spot, Whole Foods, and eat my lunch outside on my lunch break. Seasonal depression definitely on the rise. Well, no, definitely on the out.
It looks like mush, but it's turmeric rice with roasted peppers, onions, tomatoes.
It's time to finally pick up my favorite. I literally was not getting these for maybe a couple of months. I'm trying to cut down on my sugar so I could fit my bikini. And it's just one of those days where I need my chocolate pretzels.
I also love Synergy's seasonal flavor.
Today's outfit, gray blazer, pinstripe gray pants, just basic blue tee, leather jacket, and New Balance. A couple day old hair, but those scrunchies doing well. Look at that. Look at that blowout keeping.
Went ahead and picked up these guys. I've tried the spot dot before. I really liked it. And then the nose patch, because why not?
I currently have this like deep pimple, won't go away. And then I have this guy. So I think I'm gonna do the deep blemish on this one. And then the spot treatment on this one. Because that's what it says on the package. I kind of wanted to do the spot deep blemish on this because like, I've already washed my face, deep blemish. It's really interesting. It has like this spike on one side, spikes on one side, and then I just like don't really know. Yeah, and then it has like little cuts to help you peel it. That is genius. Ooh,
I feel that. That's like, ooh.
And then now for the nose patches. This is what we got. Mishy, what do you think?
I think of mommy's nose.
Good morning. I thought this would look a little bit more goopy. That means my nose just doesn't have shit in it.
All right, I'm on my way to Tierra WHACK's album release party. Wearing this jersey I thrifted. It's literally a children's jersey. This leather jacket I thrifted. Jeans, belt thrifted. It's at Webster Hall. I've actually been friends with her creative director since high school. We went to high school together and he's a year above me. Through him, I met her manager and I've stayed in touch with all of them. I still see friend Nick from time to time and she has a show in New York. So I'm excited to see Nick, Johnny. Actually ran into Johnny at the Nylon Fashion Week event. I'm really loving her new album, so I'm excited for the show.
If you're here for happy endings, fly to Bangkok.
Amazing. She did so well. I'm not one to like move or dance. I enjoyed myself. I was chatting, I was talking to people. Already downtown. I'm going to a blonde to meet up with my SD. Maybe see Nick. I have to stay with Tierra until, you know, she's finished doing her thing. Maybe I'll see him, maybe I won't.
Socializing a high, which is like rare. I'm like ready to pop around the city. Who is available, who's free, who's doing what? Like I can rule the world.
Got two new lights and my dad here to replace these two.
I'm heading to my friend's birthday. It's a little disco-y drag show.
This is what I'm wearing. Funky top. I don't have anything disco-y. Jeans, boots, because I think the heel gives go-go. Jacket, pop of color, my inner corner, and glasses.
Yeah. While I'm out, my dad's changing my light. Just picked up some tulips. Love to get my friends flowers for their birthdays, and I always get tulips when I can because it's really nice when you give it to them and they're closed, and then the next morning they wake up and see them bloom. Hopefully I make this bus because the subway's a little bit out of the way for me. The reservation's in 6 minutes.
Go ahead and sit down, Rachel. How old are you today? Oh! Clever little witch. Happy birthday!
I love the way you work it!
You're gonna just notice the story of her close friend.
The menace of the subway.
Hello. I came home from the B-Day brunch and the drag show was so much fun. Their performances were iconic. Afterwards, we went to Monarch Rooftop in Midtown. It's a cute rooftop. It has a view of the Empire State Building. It was so nice out and it was kind of empty. It was like the middle of the day, so we had a whole nice area to ourselves. On my way to meet my dad at a bar, we're doing dinner and karaoke tonight. May I do shout out Papa Sanzo? All day when I was at my brunch was changing my light fixture, cleaning behind my oven. It was just being a superstar. Superstar dad. Cutest thing ever. I'm so grateful. I love him so much. Sent me the sweetest text. I couldn't be more grateful. Thank you, Dad.
Can we appreciate this wonderful job my dad did? Like, look at these lights. Gorgeous. I got these medallions off Amazon. They're like $25 for the pair. And it comes in a bunch of different designs. And then these lights were from IKEA and they're only like $40-something. It's so pretty. I'm going to dinner with my friend Amy. I haven't seen Amy in a while, so I'm excited to like catch up. Going to Raina
month in by Union Square. Maybe I'll be seeing Danny after at some party at Jeans. I don't know. So I kind of dressed both. I have these naked wide leg high-waisted jeans and this zip up that I got from Depop. A little slick back hair moment. Look how long that pony is. I did my lip stain, but in the shade Hazel, not pinked. And oh, is my Puerto Rican side coming out. Also, I got the BK Beauty concealer and foundation brushes off TikTok. I fell for it. But when I tell you all my insecurities about how I feel like I've just lost my skills in makeup went away, it was just the stupid beauty blender. Trying to figure out what sweater to wear with these Adidas pants and Steve Madden boots because I'm meeting Kara and Joe's for coffee. But it's like really hot in here with the sun out, but actually like 37 degrees, so it's cold outside. But I originally had this naked sweater on that I might just put back on. It's just the colorway I wasn't vibing with. And I decided on this really old Urban Outfitters purpley sweater, vintage, thrifted, oversized black leather jacket, my new Depop purse. Not sure the vibe. Hi, baby. Not sure what this is. I gotta go, it's too late to figure out what this is. I feel like it kind of works. Not every day is a sleigh.
That was
cute. The coffee place.
Is this your vlog debut?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Meet Josiah.
Debut. Shawty's a window shopper.
And you know Carol.
Hi.
We got coffee.
Matcha.
I got regular latte. And Joe's is crazy and just gets a regular coffee.
With nothing in it.
We got a little croissant. And what are the pastries that? The pink. What's the pastry name that you like?
The bombolones.
Yeah, that.
Bussy. No, what was that thing you just did? Yeah, what? What was it? That's not
my
a bombolone.
What?
It's not bussy.
Oh, my. It's not bussy? Now we're going to the Kith Women's Store.
I need a few more months of my new salary to get that.
Yeah. I told myself I need to save money.
Are you allowed to try them off? Oh, those are sick. I'm obsessed.
Oh.
Daddy.
Want. Also, kind of want. We had such a productive day.
Take five.
We had such a productive day. Kelly and Marissa came over and we booked our flights. We just got the call. Booked our Airbnb. Still gotta book another flight and another hotel. Because we're flying to Athens round trip. And then we have to either fly or ferry from Athens to Paros.
Yeah, I didn't get the notification
yet. In 3 months. In three months. And then you're... Look. Get excited for the June vlog! We're going to Greece. I'm headed to Philly for the weekend to spend Easter with my family. My parents and my sister live in Philly, so I'm gonna take the bus there. I have to leave like now. Comfy outfit, my running shoes because they're too big to pack. I guess it's happy April now. In April, I have some friends' birthdays and it's really gonna start feeling like spring in New York, so stay tuned for New York. We got the cherry blossoms blossoming. It's just a completely different vibe.
Oh my god, time to break my back.